Your most accurate meteorologist using the only live Doppler radar. Live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella of protection.
Well, good Monday afternoon, just about 12:18 on this Monday. I'm Frank Scott here today from meteorologist Curtis Kurtz. We're talking about a little bit of sunshine now, starting to enter the picture, and that'll warm us up this afternoon. We had a lot of that cloud cover earlier this morning, and even a couple of isolated showers. A nice shot from our downtown sky cam in high definition. Current temperature here in Des Moines is at 51 degrees, so we're warming up nicely. Last hour we checked in, still in the upper 40s here in the metro. The dew point is at 38, still a blustery wind now out of the west at about 20. The humidity is at 61%. Here's some more current temperatures for you, courtesy of our CIPCO SchoolNet sites. Notice, still in the upper 40s, north of Highway 30. We're talking 52 degrees for Des Moines Christian, right around 50 for Montezuma, still hanging on to the upper 40s as well in Corden. Now, the other big story today has been the winds. These are gusts since midnight. Latimer, way off to the north, 50 miles per hour. Brooklyn, Farnhamville at 48 miles per hour, mid-40s for Carroll and Eagle Grove. And that's why we had that wind advisory in effect earlier this morning. Most of that is still confined off to the north of Highway 20, and that'll be expiring by about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Still pretty gusty up in Fort Dodge, 15 miles per hour. Again, out of the west here in Des Moines, about 20. Lamoni at 15, 22 miles per hour for Ottumwa. The higher gusts over 25 miles per hour now north and east of the metro. Satellite radar perspective shows this large area of low pressure brought us all the precipitation, even some of that severe weather this weekend. Finally moving on out behind this frontal system, this low pressure system, clearing things out as well with regards to that cloud cover. We'll zoom things in a little closer, and you can see actually west of Interstate 35 now seeing some sunshine, and that'll warm us into the low 60s this afternoon. So taking a look at future cast again, there's that low, these isobars, lines of equal pressure still sort of squeezed together. That means those winds will be a little bit blustery still early this afternoon. And as that low pulls off to the east, we're talking about a high pressure system that's going to be a fast mover. That'll bring us some sunshine for the early part of the day tomorrow, and then another system approaching by tomorrow night into Wednesday. That'll bring us our next rain chance. So here's future cast. We'll sort of put it in motion for you, starting things out about noon. Again, showing the cloud cover breaking up, and then some more clouds tonight, so we'll call it partly cloudy, and then tomorrow sort of a mix of clouds and sun, but I think we'll see plenty of sunshine, especially early in the day. And then by tomorrow night, our next rain chance. We might have to watch some of these storms. Some of these could be severe, especially off to the south and to the west of the metro. And then rain chances look to continue through the day on Wednesday and maybe even Thursday. So your forecast for today, 62 degrees again, a mix of clouds and sun, more sun to the west of the metro. Those gusty winds at times still up near 35 miles per hour, but still below wind advisory criteria. Tonight, 39 degrees, a little chilly out there, so bundle up if you're out and about and close the windows on up, or maybe throw that extra comforter on the bed. 68 degrees for tomorrow, more sunshine. And then Tuesday night into Wednesday, our next rain chance, 73 for Wednesday. And then we're cooling down once again. We're talking mid-50s by next Friday. The good news is some sunshine in there, Molly, so that'll help things out. Saturday, 60 degrees. Next Sunday, maybe another rain chance. But next weekend doesn't look bad. I know it's still a ways out, but okay. We can always look forward to
it. Absolutely. Catch our breath.
That's okay. Right.
Thanks a lot.